Hello and what is up guys, Jack here from Ezekiel Gaming HD and this is episode 11 of the Dream Team series. Last episode did great, it got over 600 likes, I only asked for 500, so I'm going to say it again, if this episode reaches 500 likes I will upload another episode tomorrow. There was a few problems yesterday with uploading because of the snow and just things to do, so sorry about that, but there probably will be two episodes maybe today, so just remember to hit that like button and we will do so. But we started off this episode by buying a new silver player because I had two dream team points to spend. I went and bought a centre back that was requested called Canoe. He's very, very fast. He's non-ray, cost me 3,000 coins, which is very, very good. He usually goes for about 4 or 5k. It's very consistent. Him and Juan with a silver goalkeeper are going to be a lot harder to get past than having one centre back and one silver goalkeeper. So I'm looking forward to this first game with him, seeing how seeing what they can do basically, and we come up against this team with a Bon Lahore and Lukaku, so I'm glad I bought those two centre backs. You'll see just how well they do. But we started off this game very, very well. Rodrigo picking up a mishap from the keeper, just parrying it away, and again Lalina coming down from the sides, cheeky cross into Pereira, or Neto Pereira, 6 minute to make it 2-0, so I was very confident. I was up in the first 6 minutes of the game, I was 2-0 up, and that can only mean something good. That gives me a confident boost that I need to beat a player with those kinds of players like a Bon Lahore, Lukaku, that kind of thing. But here you can see he does get a chance, but Canoe is so much better than my old centre back. He managed to pick that up with ease. It didn't even look hard to get the ball off him there. But Cristiano making a chance here with his 4-star skills. Goes for the rainbow flick, but he read it, I guess, or he just contained and it just come back again, and then he goes to clear it out. I think this was like the 90th minute anyway, so it wouldn't have made a big difference, but that makes it 3-0. I guess I get a few more coins, and it's just better to win 3-0 rather than 2-0. But apart from that, that was the game. It was 3-0 to me. I was through to the semi-final, not the quarter-final, because end of last episode, we entered the qualifier. That episode was the quarter, and now we are into the semi. So what I did, just like normal, I went and opened a bronze pack, keep the contracts, keep the morale, keep anything I can as usual, discard everything else that I don't think I can sell, put some of the contracts onto the players, and that's pretty much it. But I did have some players quite low on fitness and stuff like that, so I had a couple of bronze plus 20 fitness cards, I think they are. You can just see me putting them on the players now. Mainly the attackers were low on fitness because I've had them the longest, so it only made sense to put it on them. Also, I put a shooting card onto Rodrigo. I think here, as you can see, there you go, put the 5 shooting on there, and you'll see if it actually makes a difference in this game. But we've got 1 point to spend, and you know I can only buy a bronze player with that 1 point, so I didn't bother spending it. I thought if I play this game afterwards, I can then buy another silver player. But we've come up against this team, who had a pretty decent team. None of the players actually stood out to me, although I knew it was a lot better than mine. He does get off to a good start with a shot against the keeper, but it was pushed out well by the keeper. But Makada, oh, I think that's how you say his name, he puts it into the back of the net, 11th minute, and I was down 1-0. But Cristiano here going for a nice run here, 1-2, back into him, and he goes for a finesse with his left foot. Goalkeeper just got there. Brilliant save for a silver goalkeeper, I think. That's why I included it. I think this is the 24th minute. My centre defensive mid, Maruko Araujo, I don't know how to say that name, but he manages to score it. And I think he has like 84 pace, which is the main reason why he scored that. Just before there, I almost had a chance, hit the post. Both of us have hit the post now, so you can see it's a very tight game. 1-1, we've had two posts in a row, but we do get a chance here. Going on a break, and there was a really, really bad tackle. You'll see it again. He was already on the yellow. He goes and tackles into the back of me, and he got another yellow, which means he got sent off, and that's going to make the game a lot easier for me now. I think that was his centre defensive mid or centre mid, so it's going to make it a lot easier. Basically, a free ball, Rodrigo again, and he finesses it into the back of the net to make it 2-1 in the 53rd minute. So I was up. I had 11 men against 10 men. I was pretty confident, but he does go on the break here, and it's from me having possession to him having possession to a free ball. He was away, and he put it into the back of the net in the 90th minute. Typical FIFA 13 kind of style. So that means it went into extra time, and he even got a lead in extra time, as you can see here, playing a free ball. My keeper, I don't know what he's doing there. He only pushed the ball slowly into his hands, and he pushed out straight back to him. But we do get lucky here. Hits the referee. I take a shot thinking that would never go in. Maybe I can earn a corner. But it goes into the back of the net, 105th minute. And 3-all, that means it's pretty tight. Again, it's been a very tight game. I get lucky the way I tackled him, 107th minute, 4-3 to me. And then again, I managed to get through with Neto Pereira. I think he went ultra attacking or something like that. It just gave me the chance to get that kind of one-on-one opportunity. 116th minute, make it 5-3. So surely this is my game. We go on again. He's pulled his keeper out. I've managed to steal the ball off him and just power it into the back of the net from range. That was the 120th minute, so that is definitely game over now. 6-3 to me. And to be honest, halfway through that game, looking back on my own gameplay, I didn't think I'd be able to win that, but I did, so I was very glad about that. I'm now in the final. I had 2 points to spend on a player, so I went for a left back to boost my obviously my defence, because that is the main problem. We still got a bronze right back and a bronze centre mid, I think we do. So they are the main focus points after that player. So we now have 0 Dream Team points, and we just opened the bronze pack again, as you do before these important games. And I pretty much just put the left back in there and customize my team to put as much attribute cards on them as possible, as it was the final. If I win this final, I am now through to be able to use non-rare gold players, and obviously that'd be great just to win this cup first time, no problems. Like, if you can remember the bronze cup, we entered it and lost in the final about 4 or 5 times, and I really don't want a repeat of that, so hopefully we can get through this game. But the team we come up against is this team here. I mean, that's got to be the weakest team I've played in this cup so far, so I was pretty confident going into this game. But he does start off this game very well with a header into the back of the net, and I was just thinking, fuck's sake, oh, I hate this game, you know, that kind of mentality. And it only led to conceding another goal, which was a very good goal, but again, it's just I don't know if it was my defense fault, me as a player fault. But here he goes for a through ball, bounces off someone's back in the 44th minute, and that makes it 3-0, I believe. So I was like, oh my god, how am I going to win this game? 60th minute, I get it back with Lalinha, and he just puts it into the side of the net, or, you know, right at the back of the side of the net. And it gave me a little bit of hope. I was 3-1 down, 60th minute. But then I go for a goal kick, goes straight back to him, and he powers it into the back of the net. And I was just like, dude, what can I do in this kind of situation? But that is it, pretty much. I do have one chance here, which comes off the post, and then I just couldn't clear it, couldn't get it into the back of the net after that. And that is it. That is it. Game over. That is the end of this episode. I didn't win the final. I still need to win that silver cup to unlock the gold players. But if you enjoyed this episode, please remember to hit that like button, and obviously subscribe to my channel if you want to see the rest of this series in your subscription box. And until next time, guys, I will catch you later. Bye. Now moving over to the right mid, we have Cuadrado, who will cost you 700 coins. He has 90 pace with high dribbling abilities, as well as 4-star skill, makes him an absolute...